we're early on this Thursday morning. Cross country team is about ready to head off for their trip to NCCA Nationals. Joined now by head coach Eric Hamner. Then two of the standout athletes from this year. We have Ariel Young from the women's team. Then we have Kyle Beneke from the men's team. Ariel, I'll start with you. I want to reflect a little bit on last weekend. You guys were on the River States Conference Championships. The women placed second, the men placed first. You guys both finished second individually. How much fun was that for you guys? And then how much fun was it knowing you clinched a spot in NAI Nationals?
It was a lot of fun. The course was sloppy and wet and hilly, and that made it even more fun. But when we go out to a course like that, it's really who's got the toughest mind is going to get through it. And my team came together as a team, and we accomplished what we wanted to accomplish. I know that we wanted to get first. We were a good deal away from first, but it's still not out of our minds to beat Point Park. And to, it's an honor competing with them. They're a very good team, and it would mean a lot to beat them. And it means a lot to get second to them, too. So,
Kyle, like she mentioned, wasn't ideal conditions for you guys last weekend. What was kind of the biggest thing for you guys to pull together mentally to kind of get over those conditions and just run your guys' race?
The thing coach has always told us is when you step into bad conditions, it's affecting everyone. So it's a matter of mindset, it's a matter of attitude, and it's a matter of, you've trained for this, you know what you're doing, and you can use that. It can be used to your advantage far more than it can hurt you, because if you choose to tough it out and the other teams are affected by it, then that's something that you have that they never did.
I want to ask both of you. You guys can both answer. Obviously, you run this weekend at NCCA Nationals. Then next week, you guys will head out to Washington. What are kind of your individual and team goals for both of you guys looking forward to this weekend and next weekend?
This weekend at NCCAA's, we set a goal at the start of the season that we wanted to take top two. And so I think as a team would be extremely important, and definitely something we'd love to do is to take that second place or win it. And for that to happen, I know I need to individually be at least in the top five. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of what I'm looking at for this weekend. And then for NAI, it's a significantly bigger race, but we were hoping to, I believe the goal was top.
The original goal was to be in like the top 17, which is basically where Rio Grande finished last year from our conference. And to get that or better. Mm-hmm. And but really, we haven't really gotten too much to the goal setting for next week as we're taking it one meet at a time. So so we've just started focusing on this week. And then come Sunday on the drive back, we'll start gearing up for Washington. Right. So.
Ariel, what about the women's side for this weekend?
This weekend, there's been a lot of talk about top three this weekend. That's what we want to do. I think it's very possible. I know that people are going to have breakout races, and maybe other people on other teams are going to maybe have to have not so good races, but I think it's possible, and I think anything can happen. And individually, my goal is to win. So,
Coach, first off, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You've been here for a few years now. You've really kind of seen this program, turn around and really start heading in the right direction, made a lot of big strides in the past couple of years. How proud of the team were you last weekend, especially taking this huge step into the NAI?
Words can't really describe when you see something and you are there to watch it be molded into greatness, and just changing the mindset of our athletes from each year to setting higher and higher goals, and that standard of excellence is as high as it is now, to be going after conference championships every year and to be going after national qualifying, not just the NCCAA, but the NAI as well. And then to see that actually come to fruition really a year in advance, a year earlier than I had originally mapped out on paper. And so we are just so excited. I actually wasn't able to be there last week because my second son was being born. So it was a very big weekend for me, watching the program do so well, and just watch the athletes just do what they've been trained to do, just knowing what they've been taught, and even without me there, just being able to step in and run basically close to a perfect race.
Right.
So,
we're just wrapping up. I know our viewers probably kind of wondering what's going to be happening in the next few days. So your schedule's going to be a little crazy.
Yeah.
Just kind of walks through the next 5 days, what that's going to look like for you guys, especially traveling. First flying trip for you guys. Just kind of give us the day by day for that.
Yes, it's been even a learning experience for me, booking flights for 15 people on 2 weeks' notice. So it's been great. We're really excited. I know the athletes are really excited to be going to both national meets, and we're leaving and going to Memphis, Tennessee tonight, staying in a hotel, and then showing up at the course the following day to preview it, and then go out to a nice dinner that night, and then of course take care of some business on Saturday morning, and hopefully make those goals a reality, and then immediately switch gears into let's recover, let's get food in you guys, let's do everything we can do so that we can get you back home, rested, back in your routine, back into classes. Obviously, academics very important on our team, and being able to stay focused for these next 2 weeks and keep that side of things organized. And then on Thursday morning of next week, we'll fly out to Portland, Oregon, and then drive over to Vancouver and stay in a hotel there for a few nights and renting vans. And it'll be a new experience for us, and we're all really excited both to run at this championship style course this weekend, and then in the NAI Nationals, it's a kind of a European style course where they do several loops, mm-hmm. Especially for the guys. They'll be doing basically 2.5 loops of a course, so it'll be new for them as well. So. And you never know what us Ohioans can bring to the colder temperatures in Washington. I know some of the West Coast schools and warm weather states are gonna have a little tough transition and colder weather. So,
right. Well, thanks guys for coming. First off, I want to wish you guys luck this weekend.
Thank you.
Get some rest, have fun this weekend, get some wins, and get ready for next week. So. Have safe travels. Like we say, they'll be taking off this morning. They're headed down to Jackson, Mississippi for this weekend's race, the NCCA Nationals. They'll come back up this weekend, rest up for a couple days, then they'll hop on a plane, fly out to Vancouver, Washington for the NAI Nationals. You can follow all of this on Twitter and our website. Make sure you cheer them on next week. Thanks, guys.